Hey guys, welcome back. Hope you guys are doing absolutely fine. So in this video, actually I'm going to travel a lot distance, maybe a lot in the sense maybe around 200 kilometers right now. So it's about right now 8:20 a.m. This is 12th June. So actually today is my brother's marriage, so me and my mom and dad are going to attend this. And main thing, we are going to maintain some social distance, and also we are going to carry our mask, sanitizers, if possible hand gloves. So on the way, I will try to show you something. And one more thing, I have an exam at 10 a.m. So hope we could reach our destination by 10 a.m. Such that I can just sit back, relax in the anywhere in the village and write down my exam. Or else I have to stop my car in between and then I have to go for writing my exam. So hope I can get to the village by 10 a.m. and then start writing the my exam. So exam is from 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. All my college friends who are seeing the video might be knowing what are the difficulties they are facing for the online exam. So I hope they will be all will be removed sooner or later, and I hope this corona will be stopped as soon as possible. This is just a hope. I don't know when is the vaccine gonna come. Till the vaccine gonna come, you have to maintain your social distancing. You have to maintain your all the things like social distancing, practicing the sanitization, so on and so forth. So that's it guys. On the way, I'll show you some beautiful scenery as possible as it is raining. So as I told you, I will be driving along the village side. Yo. You can see how many number of pigeons are coming. There were enormous pigeons. They were going over their back. So on the way, I'll try to show you peacocks. As I told, I will be traveling along the village side. So that's it for now. See you in the car. So guys, finally reached the village. So presently on my way to the home, and road is bit choppy. So if the footage is too much shaky though, then don't compare me and don't compromise. I will try to give you as much good as possible. You can see the road is too much choppy. This is how the village road looks. The photo session has been completed. So I'm on the upside of the house. You might be feeling a little awkward. So this is how the village is looking right now. So my back, it's completely greenery, right? So that is the main thing I wanted to show you. And moreover, I don't know whether I will be going for the farm or not. If I'm gonna go for a farm, then surely I will show you. So this is the present situation. So it's presently around 25 degrees. So, and it's humid, so it's better, feeling quite little hot. I don't know whether it will be cool or not, because the house is completely filled with the branches. Let me show you a second. So this is the house, and these are the branches. As we know, it is known as a pandiri, so it is common. And here we go, this is the stone structure which was built in the British region, if I'm not wrong, in the British rule. So this is one of my best childhood memory, as I used to come over here, and the building was open right in back. Then I used to play over there, and presently there is no more memories of mine, as some of it has been some of the construction was bit down. So you can see there is only a tree on it. So this will be my thumbnail for this video. So if you watched until then, go and like the video. And if you are new to the channel, consider subscribing and hit the bell button such that it rings away. So guys, you might have not seen a well like this before. So actually it's built when I was small. I don't know when, in which year it was built, but I used to love to play over here. Whenever I used to come to my grandmother's place, so I sat down. safety precautions number one priority. So, and there is a small bird, pigeon bird over there. I don't know whether you can see it or not. Over there, a pigeon is sitting over there, and it has a small baby. Sorry, I'm not able to focus because I have a short range lens, as you know. And here was the water. And presently, this water is feeding almost all the three houses which are nearby. One is the back one is my uncle's house, and one is the beside one. So three houses are completely dependent upon this bore water, and you can think how much water it is better than... Nowadays we are seeing a lot of bores, right, which are being drilled and which are being, which are actually consuming the underground water. But in the past, we used to have the bore wells like such, and they used to fed at least 50 to 100 people based upon the size and based upon the water capacity. Actually, the mechanism is very simple. Whenever you're gonna take out the water, again from the underground, the water used to come. So the simple method, as same as a bore, but this was very useful when compared to the bore, because it is actually a natural source, so you're not gonna harm anything. But while digging, you are taking a lot of stone, and you're changing almost all the formation of the stone which happened over there. So this is the best method if you're gonna ask me. And I used to love, still now I love to actually sit over here, because you can see there is the guava tree, and there are small tree. This used to be the mango plant, not the mango, this is the flower plant. And these are some of the other flower plant like marigold, so on and so forth. So this place will be very cool when it is at the winter, not only in winter, in summer also. The main thing I used to like, that one only. And again, coming back to topic, my own favorite childhood memories. So this is the way, and there is the cattle. They are actually feeding the cattle over there. We also used to have some cattle over here, but unfortunately during some crisis time they had to sell, and now they have their own farm, I mean my uncle's, and therefore this is my story for today. So we will see whether it will be continued or not, because there has been some plan, as I will be going to my grandfather's place, hometown. So if not, I will be going back to the same, my home. So let's see, hope for the best. I'm thinking of going, starting lately from here, and going to my place is better option, because from here, the Tandu is around 70 kilometers, if I'm not wrong. And then from there, the Narsingi is around 100 kilometers, and overall it will be a lot more journey for me. So I'm thinking about going directly to the home, and going to my grandfather's place later. Yeah, hoping for the best, fingers crossed. So I'm presently going towards the farm. So this is the farm entrance over there. So waiting for my aunt and my mother to come over there. They're actually talking over their backside. So this is our little, small and crisp and beautiful village. I would like to spend some time over here, but unfortunately I have exams till 19, so I have to move out again to Hyderabad. Yeah, that's it. We'll show you some good time lapses or show slow-mo if possible. Or else, see you in next few minutes. So finally, into our farm. Hope you can have some beautiful views. So actually, since past some... So it's almost all from 3 days continuously it was raining. So this is our farm, to be exactly and perfect. And this is our another well, which is used for the irrigation purpose for our farm. Also irrigation, another irrigation process for the farm. I don't know, I could be whether able to go or not, because it is actually the river which is used for the irrigation purpose. So I don't think you could be able to see. So this actually, there is some water over there right now also. So this is used to irrigation. This is used for irrigation in this farm, in our farm. But unfortunately, present it is completely filled with the all the grass and all the bushes. So I don't think you will be able to see. But in rainy season, once in a while ago, I don't remember what is the time. Before some long years ago, actually the flood was there was flood, and this land was almost all filled with water, and also there was some landslide, and some of our land also went to the river. I don't know exactly about it, but I only know that we lost some land because of the water. I mean the high stream of water. So I think it has been restored right now, the land, but unfortunately I can't show you anything. There's only some leafy vegetables over here right now. Presently, just now I got to know that we also have some drumstick plants over here in our mim. Can I have it once? So this is some of the rotten drumstick which I wanna show you. So there are a number of plants over there. So I'm heading towards there right now. Let's see what we got over there. It's enough. Kashtam babe. So guys, actually I thought of taking it for a long ride, but it's quite hard. So I think I am not I'll not be able to do it. So on my right you are seeing the apple bay trees, and on my left these are the drumstick trees and plants. But the most interesting thing I like over here is that the crisp and the hearings from the birds which are on my back. Okay, just I will be silent for 1 or 2 minutes. Hear them.